Hi there, this is Guilherme Henriques. I'm a filmmaker who's been directing a good amount of metal music videos for the past 6 years since I graduated from the Cinema University. This is a series of brief moments in which I analyze some of my past work, what I've learned from it, and some curiosities about being an artist working among other artists and how that reflects on my creation process. On the second episode of Music Video Talks, we go back quite a few years to the wormed Compatronium Pulsar Nanarchy music video, released on this exact day on March 24th in 2016. Wormed were the second foreign band I had the pleasure to work with back in 2016 when I was getting started. And the first clip I did for a band from Season of Mist. I do remember the pressure I felt back then. It was also the first clip in which I was working with a label-specific deadline and everything had to follow according to their release schedule and their promotional plan for that album. With that said, me and the boys drove all the way to Madrid with a small gear I owned back then in order to pull out a very fast-paced tech death metal video for one of the kings of their genre. I think this was also the last music video in which Calero performs. An unbelievable drummer with a bright future ahead, who was sadly gone too soon. Shot in Casa de la Música in Fuenlabrada, pretty close to Madrid, this shoot took us a full day of preparation plus another full day of production. We decided to build the production set on the venue's floor since we needed a lot of space to place the lights in the ceiling and we needed to have a black box without any light spill from the exit doors and other kind of distractions. This was the first time I was shooting very talented musicians who were true masters of their craft and with a very particular and strong presence in the camera. That aspect blended with a very fast-cutting element and truly intensifies the punch and diversity of the whole clip. I remember I was quite overwhelmed and obsessed into the idea of shooting as many practical effects I could in camera and not being imprisoned to what the post-production work would solve. It's a work model I still try to follow as much as I can, even today. The way I shot this video, shaking the camera, the frantic focus and zoom pulling, gave, in my opinion, an organic flavor to the project, blending it so well with the actual song. One of the key elements here is the conceptual detail we try to implement throughout the recreation of Crisu's lyrics and the 3D visuals and modeling. I believe a lot can be achieved once you're confident of your role as a filmmaker and you know how to use the equipment you have at your disposal. Looking back at it, this clip still looks a high-budget project, even though it truly wasn't in terms of gear. It's all shot in my first DSLR camera, a Canon 600D with a 24-105mm lens, but with a hell lot of passion into what it was for me, one of the clips that put me in the radar to work with more bands in the future.